Ms. Shailaja Dyawarkonda, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's session, we are going to study bearing of survey length and its classification. At the end of this video, the viewers will able to know, define bearing of a survey line and explain the different types of bearings and their uses. The bearing of survey line is the horizontal angle made by the survey line with respect to the meridian. Meridian means normally we will use the compass to measure the bearing of survey line. The bearing is used to represent the direction of one point to the relative other point. Now, in this figure, these are the magnetic direction, that is north south and south east and west. The survey line P is making the horizontal angle 48 degree with the north direction. So as shown in this figure, the line joining the instrument station and the point P is making horizontal angle 48 degree with respect to north end of the meridian. North end means it is north-south pole. To measure this horizontal angle, we will use the compass for the measuring angle. Compass is having the magnetic needle which will indicate normally north and south pole. Meridian. It is the geographic north-south direction with reference to which bearings are measured. There are three types of meridians: true meridian, magnetic meridian, arbitrary meridian. True meridian means this is the line of intersection with the surface, with reference of the surface of the earth. It means it is the geographical line of the intersection with respect to the surface of the earth. And the angle measured with respect to this true meridian is called as true bearing. In this figure, this is GN is indicated as geographical north direction, and second one is magnetic meridian. Magnetic meridian means it is the point on the ground level which will indicate the north-south pole. So here MN indicates that magnetic meridian, and the angle measured with respect to this meridian is called as magnetic bearing. So in this figure, the survey line B makes an angle 67 degree with the geographical north-south pole, that is true meridian, and it is making angle 102 degree with the magnetic meridian. Third one is arbitrary meridian. Arbitrary meridian means it is the fixed point which is referred for the survey of any project on the ground. Means you have to notify or you have to fix up one permanent station point to the reference of the survey line. Forebearing and backbearing. In this figure, there is one line, that is line AB, or you can say it is the survey line AB. So here we have indicated the north direction. When we move from station A to station B, so it is called as forebearing of the line AB, and it is measured with respect to the north direction in clockwise. And for the same line, if we measured or if we start with station B to station A, it is called as back bearing of the line AB. So for one survey line, we will get two bearings, that is forebearing, and second one is back bearing. Means it is when you start from first station to second station, that is from A to B, so you can say forebearing of line AB is theta with respect to north direction. And when you comes from station B to A, it is called as back bearing of the line BA with respect to the north. So here we will get The relation between forebearing and backbearing is plus minus 180 degree. If the forebearing is less than 180 degree, in that case the backbearing is 180 degree plus forebearing. If your forebearing is greater than 180 degree, in that case backbearing is forebearing minus 180 degree. So it is vice versa. If forebearing is less, so it is 180 plus backbearing is 180 plus forebearing. If it is greater than 180, so it is forebearing minus 180. So for one survey line you will get the two bearings, that is forebearing and backbearing. Now included angles. What is mean by included angle? When we take a survey line, if you join the two survey lines, it will create one angle in between them. So if you observe these figures here, this is the closed traverse, or you can say it is, these are the survey lines, that is AB, BC, CD and D. So we can say it as a closed traverse, A, B, C, D and E. So here when we will join the survey line AB and AE, it will create angle A. So these angles are called as included angles. So there are two types of included. There are two types. One is interior angle and one is exterior angle. So inside the figure it is called as interior angle, and outside the figure is called as exterior angle. Normally the interior angles are less than 180 degree. If you observe this figure number 4, in this all these interior angles, angle A, B, C, D and E, are less than 180 degree. But it is not like that, it is same for the all cases. If you observe this figure number 5, in this angle A, B, C and E are the less than 180 degree angles, but angle D is greater than 180 degree. So the included angles may be less than 180 degree or may be greater than 180 degree. It is depending upon the site conditions or the survey how you have carried out. Now you can pause this video and find the included angles of this bearing system as shown in figure. In this figure they have shown the four bearing of the all the bearings, that is A, B, C and D. So first these are the four bearings of the survey lines and these are the back bearings of the respective survey line. Here you can find the included angles depending upon the forebearing and back bearing of the survey line. So may you have the answers. Now there are two types of bearing system, that one is whole circle bearing system and second one is quadrantal bearing system. In whole circle bearing system we will measure all the angles, horizontal angles, with respect to the north direction only, and those are in clockwise direction. If you observe in this figure here, the line AB is making angle with reference to the north direction, or you can say it is the bearing of line AB. At same, the line BC is making the angle with respect to north direction in clockwise. So these are the four bearings of the respective lines, that is forebearing of line AB. Here for this angle is forebearing of line BC, this angle indicates the forebearing of line CD and forebearing of line DA and forebearing of line EA. So in whole circle bearing system we have the angles 0 to 360 degree. Because we are measuring the horizontal angles or bearings with respect to the north direction and in clockwise direction only, so we will get here the angle 0 to 360 degree. Then reduced bearing system. It is also called as quadrantal bearing system. It is called as quadrantal bearing system because we will use the quadrants to measure the bearings of the respective lines. It means if you observe station A, the line AB having the bearing with respect to north direction. If you observe the station B, the line BA, or you can say the back bearing of line BA, it is measured with respect to the south pole. So the quadrantal bearings or in quadrantal bearing system, the bearings are measured with respect to north and south pole. Here the conversion of whole circle bearings to the reduced bearing. If you observe figure number 9, here the survey line makes the 132 degree angle. If I convert it into reduced bearing system, so how you will convert? So north and south pole is getting 180 degree. If I subtract this 180 for this horizontal angle within 180 degree, so I will get 42 degree. So in reduced bearing system, we will indicate the bearings as south 42 degree east, means this 42 degree is with respect to the south pole. So here also same. The next, conversion of reduced bearing to the whole circle bearing system. In this figure here, it is shown as south 48 degree east, means this survey line is making 48 degree with respect to the south direction. So if I convert it in whole circle bearing system, it is the total south and north pole is 180 degree. So if I subtract this 48 degree from the 180 degree, so you will get the 132 degree from the north direction. So likewise, you have to convert the whole circle bearing system to the reduced bearing system, or the reduced bearing to the whole circle bearing system. These are the references referred for this video and for the further study. Thank you.